So I was shuffling around the house, like looking everywhere for this camera. It's aggravating. I couldn't find it anywhere, and finally I turned it up, and so now you get to watch this shit. So basically, I just, if you haven't watched it already, you should go watch Thunderfoot's latest video where he sits down with some members of the Westboro Baptist. I'm a little jealous of Thunderfoot here. I'm jealous because he had this opportunity to actually sit down and talk to, talk to is the wrong word, but be in the same room with and try to have a conversation with the Westboro Baptist in one of their myriad forms. I mean, they're B-list Westboro Baptists, but they are Westboro Baptists. I mean, you know, there can't be more than like, you know, 50 or 60 of these people. I mean, they're all related to each other, which really says an awful lot about their theology, don't you think? But I thought Thunderfoot, you know, was valiant in his his handling of the entire thing, the full interview, which you can go watch on his channel, and I'll put a link to it down below. You know, I've definitely had I've had a bone to pick with Thunderfoot. The first video was a bone to pick with Thunderfoot. Can you tell I've been boozing it? Anyway, one of the things, there was an old crone there with Thunderfoot. This warped, spent, broken, angry crone that was there with Thunderfoot, and a young lady who had promise and potential and a life to live sitting opposite her. And it put me in mind of a BBC documentary that came out some time ago. I forget the guy's name. Sorry. But the same impression, this young person who had their whole life ahead of them and was so fresh and not bitter and evil and twisted like the elder generations of the Westboro Baptists. Sorry, sorry guys. I'm sorry to call you guys twisted, but you guys are twisted as twisted. I mean, incredibly twisted. Your dad is an incredibly twisted man, and man, has he twisted you guys up. How hard has he twisted you guys? How hard? He is your God. Deep down inside, he is your picture of God. When you hear God's voice banging around in your cranium, don't you hear your dad's voice? Don't you hear it? Yeah, you do. But man, those kids, some of those young kids, they're not quite, they're like a generation removed, and they're not quite as fucked up as you are. And you know what? They're gonna break free. They're gonna break free of your fucked up, twisted cult. That's the thing that I hear in their voice. I can hear a brightness, a lightness, an openness to living and to experience. They haven't been crushed quite yet. Oh man, how that's gonna break your twisted heart when they fly free away from you. How that's gonna disappoint you. And the patriarch. Oh, when they finally, the scales fall away, to borrow a Christian parlance. When the scales fall away and they actually see through your bullshit and the manipulative, abusive way in which that old man has twisted and manipulated everyone in his reach. I thought that, you know, to recap, simply closing. I mean, I'm drunk, so I mean, what do I know? I'm a reprobate. I know, I'm a Calvinist as well, but I mean, I'm a reprobate Calvinist, which means that I understand that I'm not going to make it, but I do believe that everybody's predestined. That's irony. That's a joke. Anyway, damn, recap. Yeah, recap. Thunderfoot, you know, you really came out smelling like a rose on that one, dude. You were really quite the gentleman, and no reason to think you wouldn't be, really. But kudos to you for being a gentleman, and God, I don't know. I don't know what else to say. What a stifling experience that must have been to be in the same room with those people. Oh, man. I don't know what to say. I grew up around that sort of thing. Literally, just a gnat's ass hair away from that literal reality. That's what I grew up with. Nobody I grew up with would have picketed soldiers' funerals, but, man. Somebody needs to make a It Gets Better series for fundamentalist Christians. It gets better, folks. I mean, it doesn't. You still have to live here. I mean, life's hard. You know, life is hard and it's full of consequences. But it does get better than the fundamentalist wacko crazy that you may have been raised with. You're gonna make it. You're gonna raise your own family, love your kid, give them a hug, teach them right and wrong, you know, and have some logical reasons to back up right and wrong that make sense to a child and to an adult. And you can show them. You can show them a world free of angry, sick old men forcing their will on you. And that's fucking awesome. So, it gets better. A car?